Hello, everyone. Tall Chris here, and welcome to the very first part of the Night Home Raid, actually. We did it in the exact reverse order. I am a guardian. I guess it kept me marking tank, and it's giving me, what do you call it? It's giving me the satchel for it, so I'm okay with this. I really am. Because the satchel is a beautiful thing. Not only does it give me free creeping artifact power, but it also gives me extra Blood of Sargeras, extra whatever those things are that I sell in the auction house for gold. It basically just makes me cool. And that makes me that bad shit. I'm gonna move this up here. I actually probably have close to another artifact power up here. I need 182,000. It's about 32. Yeah, it's about 32,000. I'm close. The first boss is always difficult to take out. He has more health than any other. I mean, I say he has more health, but he's got him passive like armor thing. That's okay. I'm perfectly fine. I got the Lost Guardian for that. I need to get sort of too common on this. It did not happen. I just kept getting it. I ended up getting the Lost Guardians instead. Or the Corrupted Guardians, which I've already recorded for you guys, but Ursoc was already dead, or Ursul was already dead, and that was the one boss that I wanted, because I was just trying to unlock his artifact. I may actually just record a video of me fighting him, because, you know, there's always a chance that the artifact is going to drop. I'll make the video, and I will name it how to get the Hidden Guardian artifact skin. I'm sure everybody already knows how to get it, but I will name it how to get the artifact skin. How to get it? It's literally quite resolved. First of all, in any difficulty, no matter what there's LMR, heroic, mythic, he has a chance to drop it. I don't think upping the difficulty increases your chances of getting it. I think that it's the same no matter what. I wasn't about to die, but I know the mechanic. Get behind the bullshit before you die. No, we have only extra scrubbits here. Really not all that worried about them either. This fight is literally just don't die and damage. None of his abilities really matter all that much. He does have flash babies, but that's really good. Right now, when it's armored damage, it's like the perfect time to pop a red, where all of your damage really counts. Where you can heal damage and then fight the armor. My sister's already tried fighting the monster off the ground really quick. You just hop behind and they run away. You just go to the crystal. You don't feel the crystal. It is possible to defeat by killing the scorpion as they come in, and I kind of stop the mechanic because you're not getting it. But at that point, you're always fighting scorpion, so you kind of have to focus blast, you just want to stay out of it, like a straight line ability, and stun that does the math. It won't really one-shot you, but it'll do enough damage to piss you off. It would probably one-shot you on heroic, I think. On normal mode, it's really not super deadly. It hurts, but it's, you know, like I said, it's not something we don't shut off. It's not as fucking deadly as that's me taking damage, but it's almost unnoticeable. But you see, he changed his abilities, and I got stunned. And then I immediately the artifact this power. This is a momentous day, my friend. That is another tank buff I can use.
No outsider was permitted inside the corridors of the Nighthold.
A lot of people
10,
got
beat up.
Say I'm a little jealous, but I'm really not, because I don't want to get any more loot until I get to Ursaan, because I really, really want the hidden artifact skin. I've already used all of my extra loot rolls this week. I had 4. I already burned all of them. I was at a point where I was just using my extra loot rolls on Ursaan himself, or on the Earth. I'm pretty sure it's Ursaan. I'm pretty sure Ursaan is... I'm pretty sure Ursaan is the other brother. Yeah, it's Ursaan. Okay, so yeah, I was using my extra loot rolls on Ursaan specifically to try and get the extra guardian skin, the hidden one, but I just never got it. So I've kind of given up on that, and I've decided that I would rather use my extra loot rolls to try and gear myself a little bit better so that I can queue for a Nighthold normal run with Pugs, because I need to be geared if I'm going to be running with Pugs. And like I said, my guild is always running with Waller, and that is like the worst possible thing. To work the days that you're doing, yeah, let's do a new raid, guys! Because then you're evil. Absolutely. And it sucks because I'm a tank, so to be one of my guild's tanks and not be important because I'm always working is like, it's just one of those things that absolutely bites. I already missed out on the Emerald Nightmare. Now I'm missing out on fucking Nighthold because of my schedule. But that's okay because I can pug it. And once I finish upgrading my artifact weapon, I won't have any problems at all. This is... It's nowhere near as much as I thought it would be. I'm only at 97,000. Wow. My math skills. Don't want to wait. Down this boss as quick as possible. I want to get up to Trilliax. I want to down Trilliax as quick as possible. Come on, guys. Like, for real. They're not difficult. Go. Follow me.
Come with me if you want to live.
His shield is annoying as shit, and I don't have any DPS guys, look, if you all come down here, it'll follow you down here, and we can all murder it together while we're in the shield, and we get the other shield. I am not able to do. Alright, I've got the other tank is already with me. Alright, so he tries to throw you in the way. There we go, he's dead. He did. Alright, what do we have here? Yeah, okay, the boss is spawned in. I figured I could have sworn I remembered the boss being spawned in at all times. And you kind of have to be able to do it with him here without pulling him. But I wasn't 100% sure, so I wanted to go. He's really cool. He's the time boss. He affects the flow of time. And that is a pretty hook. He'll slow time down, he'll speed time up, and he'll have the normal time phase. There's the boring time, the stressful time, and the oh my god, I'm so fast time. The I'm so fast time is obviously the best. The normal time is a little bit boring, and the slow time, or the slow time is boring. And stressful. Yeah, but the fast time is fun. It's just stressful because I'm sitting here and I'm like, none of my abilities are good enough. What the fuck? Why? Pop. Bloodlust. I know it's called heroism for the Alliance, but who wants to move called heroism? Bloodlust. It's called Bloodlust. Bloodlust! Because it's so much fun. Alright, he's dying excessively quick. I mean, I guess I should have figured that before the Scorpion boss dies. Because even with the Scorpion boss's armor, he went down. We have a Death Knight pulling 1 million damage a second. That's pretty high. I've ever seen. And that's saying a lot. 13% of the team. obvious in my groups in Guardian, but that's because I've had like mad fucking issues. Even single target, I'm still pretty high up there, so if somebody is doing that much damage, I'm kind of dead. And he's still staying up there, he's at 940,000. That is pretty fucking ridiculous. Our target tank is dead. I must have been. I forgot. We'll just say that. I forgot. I was so caught up in the DPS of the Death Knight, I forgot. Oh well, my bad. You can go ahead and let me get a bunch of stacks. I'm not worried about it. Honestly, I've really been getting how many stacks I have. Taking some damage. Alright, well, I've got survival. This motherfucker, he's mine. Give him back. Distracted me to the point where I let my other tank die. Alright, let's see. He's got a fucking legendary helmet. He's got 900. Not, wow. 890, 875, 900, 907. What the fuck? Alright, yeah, so he's geared. He is pretty ridiculously geared. I like that. I like that a lot. His average item level is probably close to 900. My average item level is 842. So, I mean, that goes to show the difference. He has clearly been raiding for a while in this expansion.
Unless he managed to claw his way out from under 2 tons of solid stone.
And that's a pretty fucking sick thing. I mean, that is an amazing thing to have that much fucking.
Considering I still have his hands in a jar.
That damage. He's not top right now, but I mean, this is a multi-target fight. And I think he was a frost. Alright, now it's this big fucking skull bastard. All together and merge on the skull. Please. We just gotta kill him. And he's not even a boss, he's like a mini boss. Specifically for the RP element of the zone now. And he explodes, clicks, gets pissed off, and then goop all over the floor. Freaks out.
Tracking mud everywhere!
Tracking mud everywhere! I honestly had loved Trilliax specifically for his character. Like, he's a multiple personality single role. And his different personalities are different phases. And I fucking love him. He is by far one of my favorite bosses. I, like, there's Xavius, and I love to kill Xavius, but I kill Xavius for revenge. For Yasara, I kill fucking, I want to kill Gul'dan, I haven't actually gotten him yet, but I want to kill Gul'dan and revenge King Varian, because King Varian was, like, one of the coolest World of Warcraft lore characters ever, and he got fucking killed in one of the dirtiest fucking nasty games possible, and I fucking hate him. So, like, one of my goals is absolutely fucking annihilate. So this is the, they call it the annihilation phase, the annihilator. You just gotta avoid the annihilator beam. I'm pretty sure it's not fatal. It's not fatal here on Pathfinder. But the damage is picked up on normal mode and on heroic. On mythic, it is a one-shot no matter what. Like, heroic, you might be able to survive it with decent enough gear. But on mythic, you are fucked if you let it go that annihilator beam. So, alright, he's back into tidy up mode, he's back up again. I mean, the reason we do this is, like, we try to keep him around the edge of the room. I try to keep him around the edge of the room because that is how you should fight him. You want to kite him around the edge of the room, and you want to try and kind of keep the pool a little more behind him. A little bit off to the side here where my mouse is, so that when he enters the annihilator phase, the middle of the room is not covered, and the edge of the room is covered. Because you want to be able to have clean space so you guys can actually walk around in without worrying about getting hit by it. Because slime is bold. I mean, it really doesn't do much damage. In all honesty, I can put two stands this whole day, and it does 125,000 damage. Out of my million, that's actually not that much. But it's enough. Get it. Tiny the robots actually get a buff if they get the cake. I believe I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure the robots actually get a buff. But that is it for the beginning part of Nighthold. So now we are 100% done with Nighthold until either A, we actually start the raid, which hopefully will be sometime next week, or B... Oh, wow. All right. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. You are awesome. He apparently was looking at my loot. I'm going to lose critical, I'm going to lose haste, but I'm going to gain a fuck ton of mastery, and my item level is going to shoot through the roof. That I love when people do that. It makes me feel so good to just see. And it's funny, because when I just did the Tormented Guardians, I got a piece of loot, and I was like, hey, does anybody need this? Because it's like a fucking 835. What am I going to do with an 835? So when people just randomly like run up to me and trade me like that, it always makes me feel good, because it's like, it goes around, you know? What goes around comes around, and it fucking came around. I got a piece of gear, and it was much better than mine. My item level went up by 2 points, and I feel good about it. Anyways, that is it for this video. I appreciate you guys being here with me for this until, like, 3 in the morning. It was really nice to have somebody here to talk to, and, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps us out a lot. And as always, I will see you in the next one. I was going to kill Xavius just to kill Xavius. He needed to die, even though I've already killed him this week. But I think I'm going to decline that one because I queued up for it for the satchel. The satchel's gone. Anyways, bye-bye!